हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट ईयर वी ऑलरेडी लर्न हाउ टू इंसर्ट इमेज ऑन वेब पेज एज वेल एज हाउ टू कन्वर्ट सिंपल इमेज इन टू द हाइपर इमेज. सो फॉर इंसर्टिंग इमेज ऑन वेब पेज वी रिक्वायर वन टैग एंड नेम ऑफ दिस टैग इज IMG. IMG टैग हैविंग नंबर ऑफ एट्रीब्यूट्स. वी ऑलरेडी लर्न दैट एट्रीब्यूट्स. एंड फॉर converting simple image into the hyper image we required another tag by using the img tag. This is nothing but anchor tag. So img tag is always placed in between opening anchor tag and the closing anchor tag. So what is the meaning of hyper image? Hyper image is nothing but by using one image we can jump on another page. In short, we can connect another web page by using the image. Such type of image is called a hyperimage. So whenever allocated area for the image, so after clicking anywhere on the image, we can connect with the another web page. Such type of concept is called a hyperimage. So when we are creating a hyperimage, so one image is linked with only one web page. Such type of concept is called a hyperimage. Now this year we will learn some advanced part related to image. This is nothing but image map. Now when I compare with the image map and hyperimage, both are used for connecting with the web page, but hyperimage connect with single web page. Whereas when I create the image as a image map, so by using the single image we can allocate number of allocated areas and we can connect one image with the number of web pages. Such type of concept is called a image map. Image map, an image with multiple hyperlinks is called an image map. Image map is used to connect links to different regions on the web page. An image map is created by marking certain regions on the image clickable. These clickable regions are called hotspots. Now I am showing with the simple image. Assume this is my web page. On the web page, there is one image is there. Assume name of my image is the flower.jpg. When I am executing that web page, so we can see one continuous image. We can't see that dotted areas. Now, what is the image map? Assume this is my one image. On this image, I can allocate some clickable area. These dotted areas are a clickable area. They are also called a hotspot area. Means whenever I am moving or when I am putting my cursor on the image, it's a look like one arrow. But whenever I am putting my arrow or cursor on that dotted area, so it will switch from arrow to hand sign. That means click on that area, we can jump on another page. So when I am putting my cursor on that rectangular area and internet connection is there, so my page is, yeah, my image is connect with the Google page. When I am clicking on that poly in a triangular area, then my image is jump on a Yahoo page. And third is the my local page. This is my mydemo.html. When I am clicking on that circular area, so my page is connect with that local page. This is a mydemo.html. So this is my single image, and this single image having some hotspot area, clickable area, allocated area, number of names are there. So by using that area, we can connect with the number of web pages. Such concept is called a image map. Now image map, there are two types of image maps are there. First is a client side image map and second is a server side image map. The image map which is executed on a client side computer, such type of image map is called a client-side image map. The tags used to define a client-side image maps are, there are three tags are there. First one is a IMG, second one is a map, and third one is a area tag. These three tags are required for creating a client-side image map. Now let's start. First tag, this is the IMG. IMG tag is used to insert an image on web page. To create a client-side image map, useMap attribute of IMG is used with value, which is preceded with hash symbol. It's a very important part. The useMap attribute indicates that the image is a client-side image map. Now, next type of tag which is used for creating a client-side image map, this is nothing but map. It has only one attribute, which is nothing but name. It specifies name of the image used for client-side image map. The value of the name attribute is the value specified in useMap attribute of the IMG. And next tag, it's nothing but area tag. Area tag is always placed inside the map tag. It defines specific clickable regions. Area tag is always placed inside the map tag. Area tag is a singular. Means what? If you open area tag, so there is no need to close that area tag. But map tag is a paired. Means if you open map tag, you have to close that map tag. And all area tags always placed inside the opening map tag and the closing map tag. Now there are some attributes are there with the area tag. They are nothing but first one is a href, which defines the URL to which the clickable regions within the image map navigates. Means whenever you are allocating some areas on the image, after clicking on that allocated area or hotspot area, we are jumping on another web page. So URL or path of this or address of the web page which is connected with that hotspot area, this URL is nothing but href attribute of the area tag. Now next is the shape, which specifies the shape of hotspot area. There are some shapes are there. First one is a rect, circle, and poly. These are the value of the shape attribute of the area tag. Next is the ALT. Specifies extra information about the clickable area. Means when you put your cursor on that dotted, means nothing but hotspot area. So we get some extra information about the web page by using the tooltip. For giving search type effect, we are using the ALT. ALT is nothing but alternative text. Next, the chords. For designing that shape, we require chords. Without chords, we can't design that shape. So, specifies coordinates of the clickable regions on the image map. When you are designing rect, so it specifies rectangular area with four coordinates. When I design a circle, defines a circular area with three coordinates. When I design a poly, specifies a polygon region with coordinate specifying each point on the polygon. And next one is a default, which covers entire image. No coordinates are required. Now I'm showing you how to design client-side image mapping. For designing a client-side image mapping, we required one image. So I copied one image. Name of my image is a flower.jpg. This image having three allocated area. This is nothing but hotspot area. Two hotspot area I connected with global pages. This is such met Yahoo and Google page. Whereas one hotspot area I connect with one local page. This is nothing but mydemo.html. So for that purpose, I design one web page. This is a user-defined web page and name is a mydemo.html. You can save your file with any name. This is my local page because which is created by the user and stored in a user's client machine. That's why such type of web page is called a local page. So I create one simple web page. We're having just background color orange and text color red color and one message, hello students. This is a local page. For design a local page, first write a simple basic structure. I open with the notepad file. See, HTML head title. This is my basic structure. For changing the background color, I use here BG color attribute of the body tag. And for changing the text color, I use here text attribute of the body tag. This is my simple local page. Now next is the image mapping. I already designed one code. So I'm just showing you output. Name of my page, web page is a image demo.html. Now see, when I'm open or when I execute my web page, so it's a look like a normal single image. But there are some hotspot areas are there, allocated areas are there. For viewing that allocate areas, we can press tab. So this is my rectangle area, this is my circular hotspot area and poly. This is my triangular. You can design any shape. So whenever I am putting my cursor in that rectangular area, so see, difference is there. This area when I am putting my cursor, so it's a look like a arrow. But when I am putting my cursor in that rectangular area, so here this arrow will switch with the hand sign. So I'm clicking on that area. If internet connection is there, so it's connect with the Google page. But internet connection is not there, so we can't connect with the global page. Now next area is there. This is a circular area. So when I'm clicking on that circular area, so my page is linked with the yahoo.com because I given that URL. This is a http://yahoo.com. That's why my page, yeah, my image is jumped on a Yahoo page. This is also global page. This page we are not required to create. It is already created on the server. And third area, hotspot area, allocated area. This is nothing but triangle area. There's a poly. So it's connected with the local page which I already created. Okay, and name of my page is a my demo. So after clicking on that triangular area, my image is connected with the mydemo.html. Means what? This there are I allocated three areas, rect, then next is the circle, and third is a poly. And through the single image I connect different web pages with the image. This is called a image mapping. It's called a client side image mapping. Now here I'm showing you the code. Right click, open with notepad file. See, HTML head title is a basic structure. Now here img tag for the inserting image, src, I copied flower.jpg file. That's why I'm giving here flower.jpg. If your image name is a different image, so you have to give your file name. And here use map attribute, it's a very important part. Use map indicate that this is your client side image mapping. Now use map attribute take one value with the hash. This is a very important part. It's a hash. Now another tag is there. This is a map tag which having only one attribute, it's a name. Now see, value of the name attribute of map and value of the use map attribute of the img tag is the same, but when we are passing with the use map, so that time you have to write with the hash sign. This is a very important part. Okay, if you're writing a capital case, you have to write here capital case. You can give any name, ABC, MNO, XYZ, it's your choice. Now next is the area tag. For allocating area, for allocating hotspot, we are using the area tag. Area tag is always placed inside the opening map tag and the closing map tag. Now area tag having number of attributes are there. First is the shape, second is the coords, third is the href, and fourth is the alt. It's alternative tags. See alternative tags. So shape, there are three values are there. First is the rect, circle, and poly. Okay. Now if you are designing rectangular, so we require two values, two points, top left and bottom right. XY coordinate of the top left and XY coordinate of the bottom right. Next is the href. Href having some URL you are giving. This is nothing but google.com, otherwise yahoo.com and etc. It's a global page, and my demo, it's a local page. Okay. Now here, this is a very important part, okay, how to give coordinates. Please don't by heart that coordinates. Okay, according to your image, these coordinates are changed. For note down that coordinates, open that image with the paint option. Now open this image with the paint. Open with paint. Now see, when I am moving your cursor on the image, so at bottom left side, two values are there, two pixels, they are not the XY coordinate of that point. If these two values are not there, it's not a disable, it's a disable mode. So go to the view and set status bar as a checked. Now first you have to select rect, it's a rectangle. Drag that rectangle on a image. Now put your cursor at the top left side and note down that two points, XY coordinate. Now next, put your cursor on that bottom right corner side and note down that two points. So we get four values, XY of the top left and XY of the bottom right. This is a diagonal of the rectangle. Now for drawing a rectangle or poly, the triangle, select the triangle, put your cursor on that point, note down that two XY coordinate which is on a status bar. Next put your cursor here and note down that two points, XY coordinate, and then put your cursor at on this point and note down that two values. So we will get total six values of the, if you are triangle, so six value, if you are pentagon, then 10 values. According the poly, we have to note down that values. Now next is a circle. For drawing a circle, select the circle, drag on the image, then select one line. First put your line from the approximately center toward circumference at in a straight line. Okay, now put your cursor on that center point, note down the two values, x and y. Now assume this is x1 and y1. Okay, now we draw that straight line, so y coordinate obviously it's the same, x coordinate is changed, x Now so do x2 and y2. So x2 value is obviously more or big than the x1. So for calculating the radius, we have to first write x2 value, x2 minus x1. So whichever difference is there, this is called a radius value. So first is the xy of the center, and whichever difference we get, this is nothing but radius of the circle. So we get 3 values. After noting that values, click on the close. Please click on the don't save. I am again showing you output. See, this is an image demo. This is my circle. When I am putting my circle on that hotspot area, so it will switch with the hand sign that indicate that you have to click on that area. Your page is linked with the another web page. So for designing the image mapping, we require 3 tags. They are nothing but IMG, area, and map tag. Area having number of attributes. They are nothing but href, shape with 3 values, rect, circle, and poly. ALT is also attribute of the area tag. Chords is the coordinates of the shapes. The different values are there with the different shapes. Hope you understand how to design client-side image map.